everyone, I'm Will, and today I'm going to show you how to identify groundnut. But before that, remember to like and subscribe and comment down below, and don't forget to press that notification bell down below. If you can see the flowers that are pinkish right here, those are groundnut flowers. Now, groundnut is a great plant to even grow for basically the nut. Is actually not a nut like a seed. The nut comes from the point of the root of the tuber. So the tuber has a great source of carbohydrates. Now, if you can see along all these plants, groundnut is a true vine. It loves to climb. Hence over there, there's some climbing up a few feet up some raspberries. Each flower head of the bundles of cluster of flowers are going to be about 2 to 4 inches long and about 1 to 1.5 inches in width. Now each flower is going to be 1/2 inch wide, about 1/4 inch in depth. And it's going to have this reddish maroonish hue to the coloration of the flower, very pinkish coloration also. When you look from afar, it will have a pinkish hue. The base of it, where it attaches to the plant, will be a light green. And that will be about 1/8 inch in length. When you are looking for the leaves are actually a combination of leaflets. So if you can see right here, there's 5 leaflets for 1 leaf. Each leaf, so the combination of the whole leaf right here, is going to be about 6 inches in length. And some of the leaflets can be about 7 leaflets instead of 5. So you're looking for 5 to 7 leaflets for ground bean, and about 4.5 inches wide. Now the side leaflets, these ones down below, are going to be 2.5 inches in length by about 1 inch in width. And the leaf at the top will be about 3 inches in length and 1.5 inches in width. Now the coloration of the leaves will be green on top and light green on the underside of the leaf. The leaves are very rounded, but on the bottom side of the leaf is more of like an oval shape, and it's straighter on the top for the side leaves, and it's very rounded here with a point on the top leaf. Now because ground bean is a true vine, it will be climbing up other plants to get the sunlight. Like right here, we have a hibiscus that the ground bean is climbing up, and then there's the arborvita right here that it's climbing up, and then also a common lilac all right here of what it's growing up. So it has no determined height, but it will climb to get that sunlight. Now the best time to find when it's flowering is the end of August and the start of September. Now the stem of the vine itself will be a light green and about like 2 millimeters to 3 millimeters in width. You can see right here that it's twisting up some grass, and you follow along and then it's like twisting up a little bit more grass right there. So it's trying to get the sunlight of climbing up higher. When you're searching for the ground bean at the base towards the ground, it will look like this right here. So when you found that, you want to like basically move the soil out of the way, and you can actually dig down and search where that goes, and you can follow it. So we're going to follow it of where it actually goes and harvest about 1 or 2 of the tubers. So the type of ground that we're working in is a soft ground, so sandy. And you want to work your way, and you don't want to break the plant itself, because we're going to just search for the tuber. And the tuber is, there's one right there, real quick. Now the two birds are going to be small. And there's another one. You can break those off. And I don't want to damage this section of the plant, so I'm gonna just take the two right here, the larger ones, and just break that off and then rebury this, that this can keep growing. So I have these two. And you wanna bury and pack that back in. Because then this can still go to flower and give energy, and that's its rootstock there. Now the tubers are going to be about 1.5 inches in length and about 1 inch in width. Now the coloration, when you pull them out, they're going to be a little bit dirty, but the coloration is going to be like a tannish brown to almost a light brown. Now the groundnut will have these little nodules over on the side right here, these little bumps. That's a good indicator that you have the right root, and the section of the root that's right here could be a couple inches or a couple feet long in between each of the tubers. Now the chain of the tubers could actually go about more than even 20 feet in length. So when you find one, just start following it and following it and following it, and you could actually get a very long chain of the groundnuts. In the next video, I'm gonna show you how to cook groundnut. And that's how you identify groundnut. If you wanna see more, go down in the description below, click the link to my channel, or press the round subscribe button to help me out to get to 10,000 subscribers. And until next time, remember to get outside, get fresh air, and have fun. See ya.